Welcome to the easy workflow of the EXILE Spyder II CTS system. We'll show setting up your separations in Adobe Illustrator, ripping your files to print, and imaging screens on the Spyder II. First, in Adobe Illustrator, we want to ensure that we're seeing all of our artwork colors in spot color on separate layers. Once converted to spot colors, I recommend naming each color by Pantone or ink color in the order it's going to be printed on press. We'll start here with number 3, orange, then number 2, cream. We want to ensure that print overfill is selected. Then we select the base color and name it number 1, base. In your art template, we label each screen in the appropriate spot color so it prints and images on the screen itself. Next, we'll select the print screen. We'll select the Spyder printer and in the PPD, the RIP kit. For output, we select separations hot based. We should be able to see all of our separations and ensure we're selecting the right ones that we want to print. From here, you can select your appropriate halftone lines, dots, and angles as needed. After that, we simply hit print. The Spyder II and the RIP kit are networked to my office computer that we have here. So once we hit print, they automatically rip to a new folder designated on the Spyder workstation that's set up during the installation process. We simply drag all the files over into the queue, select the one that we're going to print first, confirm the template, and then hit print to image the screen. Combined with Ryonet's Baselayr exposure system, you can see how easy this workflow is to rip, print, and expose screens. For a free download of the AI template used in this video, simply click the link below in the description. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Thanks for watching, Empowering the Print with Ryonet.